Hello friends, in today's class, let us find out the expression for radial and transverse component of acceleration. As we have discussed earlier, radial and transverse component of velocity. Similarly, we can resolve the net acceleration of the moving particle along the two directions. The acceleration along the position vector is called radial component, and the acceleration along the perpendicular direction is called transverse component. It is very clear that rate of change of velocity gives acceleration. From the previous part, we know that net velocity is given by v equal to r dot into r cap plus r theta dot into r perpendicular cap. This one is the radial component, this one is the transverse component. Now, if you differentiate this velocity with respect to time, you will be left with net acceleration. Therefore, net acceleration A equal to dv by dt, or this is d by dt of r dot into r cap plus r theta dot into r perpendicular cap. Hence, you can simplify this d by dt of r dot into r cap plus d by dt of r theta dot into r perpendicular cap. Now, you simplify this particular expression using UV formula and UVW formula. See, d by dt of the product, it is written like this. First factor differentiation of second factor plus second factor differentiation of first factor plus, here UVW formula, first two factors differentiation of third factor plus theta dot r perpendicular cap differentiation of dr by r plus r perpendicular cap differentiation of theta dot with respect to t. This is equal to r dot as it is, dr cap by dt is written as dr cap by d theta into d theta by dt. Dr cap by d theta into d theta by dt plus second term r cap, d by dt of r dot can be written as r double dot plus r theta dot as it is, dr perpendicular cap by d theta can be written as dr perpendicular cap by d theta into d theta by dt plus theta dot r perpendicular cap, dr by dt is r dot plus r into r perpendicular cap theta double dot. If you simplify this further, r dot dr cap by d theta is r perpendicular cap into theta dot plus r cap into r double dot plus r theta dot into dr perpendicular cap by d theta is r minus r cap into theta dot plus theta dot r perpendicular cap plus r theta double dot r perpendicular cap. Now, in this expression, if you club the terms containing r cap and r perpendicular cap, you are left with the following equation. This is equal to r cap, here is one r cap and another r cap is here. So, r double dot minus r theta dot square into r cap plus theta dot r perpendicular perpendicular. Therefore, 2 r dot theta dot plus r theta double dot into r perpendicular cap. Left hand side is net acceleration. See, this is how the net acceleration of the randomly moving particle is expressed as the sum of radial component and transverse component. Radial component is along the radius vector, transverse component is along the transverse direction. Therefore, radial component of acceleration AR is r double dot minus r theta dot square into r cap, and transverse component of acceleration is 2 r dot theta dot minus plus r theta double dot into r perpendicular cap. So, these are the two expressions for radial component and transverse component. Now, whenever you apply this formula for a particle executing uniform circular motion, radius vector remains the same. Therefore, dr by dt or r dot is 0 and d theta by dt is the constant angular velocity. If you substitute these values into these expressions, now ultimately you get the expression for centripetal acceleration or centripetal force. Therefore, for a particle executing uniform circular motion, r is constant, therefore dr by dt or r dot is 0, and d theta by dt, that is omega angular velocity, that is constant, or theta dot is zero, the theta dot is constant and theta double dot is 0. If you substitute these values in the above expression, let us see what is the acceleration along the radius vector and what is the acceleration along the transverse direction. Now AR is given by, means radial component of part acceleration of a particle moving along a circle with uniform velocity, AR equal to R double dot, since R dot is 0, R double dot is also 0, minus R into theta dot. Theta dot is omega, it is constant angular velocity, omega square into R cap, or this is simply minus R omega square into R cap, which implies that for a particle executing uniform circular motion, the acceleration is entirely radial, and if you substitute in the transverse component formula, entire thing becomes 0. Or in other words, a particle moving along a circular path has got acceleration along the radius vector only, and also this minus sign indicates that it is in the direction towards the center, in the reverse direction. Now if you multiply this by the mass of the particle, then the force acting on the particle is given by minus m into r into omega square into r cap, and we call this as the centripetal force. The force is acting towards the center of the circle, therefore it is known as centripetal force. Similarly, we can apply the formula for a particle moving along a circle in having uniform velocity to find out its velocity. As you know, velocity is having two components, radial component and transverse component. If you substitute r dot equal to 0 in the expression and theta dot equal to omega in the expression, you see that the velocity of a particle executing circular motion is completely transverse. There will not be any velocity component in the radial direction, but entire velocity in the transverse direction. So this is how you prove that for a particle executing uniform circular motion, acceleration, hence the force acting is always towards the center, that is the centripetal force, and the corresponding acceleration is centripetal acceleration, and the velocity is along the tangential direction. We call it as tangential velocity. It is always directed along the tangent onto the circle, and there will not be any velocity component in the radius vector. Thank you.